is coming that is far beyond you and I. This is about Egypt's survival, do you understand?
Who has been telling you this?
God.
I am a God.
I am a God!
Follow me and you will be free!
We're going to recapture 400,000 slaves.
We're not recapturing anyone.
There is a sea ahead and an army behind! Ready yourselves!
Hey everybody, Zach again at newtutorial.com. Wanted to come in and do a video for you. Wow, amazing effects. I'm watching the Exodus trailer, and I'm sure many of you have seen this too. A lot of you guys, I'm seeing the talk and chatter on social media, and everyone's looking forward to this movie. A lot of people are looking forward to the movie. I'm not going to go see it. I'm going to wait for your all's reviews to come out and see what you think. I can read your comments. And then also, there's all kinds of critics out there. You can read about what they think about the movie too. And so far, it looks like the movie's making a bunch of mistakes in the script, based on what we know from scripture, a bunch of scriptural mistakes. And so that's not to be, I mean, come on, we know that's going to happen. It's Hollywood. And so they're more interested in the movie, or in the movie script, in the story and the special effects than they are actually going and opening up their Bible and seeing what it says. And it's the same way with anything. I have in my hands right here the Cecil B. DeMille version of the Ten Commandments, starring what I think is and always will be the only Moses besides the Moses, and that's Charlton Heston. And he, I mean, it was a great movie. I think it's probably the pinnacle of the story of the telling of Exodus and Passover, and that this is probably the best movie version ever that's going to be on the silver screen. Already it's being talked about that Christian Bale does not play the role of Moses very good. The critics are coming out, people who have seen pre-releases of the movie, that he just doesn't fit into the role very well. His acting's not very good. And I even read one critic who said that, you know, they may pass over altogether the role of best actor for the Oscars for when it comes to this movie. He may not even get a shot at being at one of the contenders for best actor. And so, I don't know too much about the other guy who plays Pharaoh, but Yul Brynner in this movie, I think, was the pinnacle of that character when it came to playing the part of Pharaoh. And if you're like me, maybe you've done research that Ramses was probably not the Pharaoh at the time anyway when this took place. And so that's a whole other video in itself. But anyway, the movie's coming out. People are excited. The effects look amazing, just like the effects did with the movie Noah that came out. And everyone knows that that movie, I mean, they didn't even, the guys who wrote that movie didn't even own a Bible, I guess, when they wrote the storyline of that movie. But it looked great, you know, it looked good. I mean, you know, good special effects, you know, can make up for a whole bunch of errors in story. So anyway, that's what we're kind of looking forward for this movie. Charlton Heston is really the pinnacle, I think, in when it comes to the storytelling of Moses. But we'll see how it does, and I can't wait to hear some of your reviews. Anyway, what I think is really going on here is a bunch of distractions. The world is throwing out all kinds of movies when it comes to the Bible. They want to get the world to understand what you should think of the Bible, and that's just it's a really great storybook that can be interpreted really any number of ways. And that's really what the enemy is doing right now. He's sending out tons of distractions your way. Bang, 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 bang. And what these are distractions. Bang, bang, bang. And he's trying to keep you focused off what you should be focused on, being entertained rather than learning and knowledge and what the Father has for us, for his people, and that's to come back and come back to the instructions, the Torah that he has given his people to be followed forever throughout their generations. And so he's going to throw just all kinds of distractions at us, and a lot of those are going to include Bible movies. So people can go to the movie theater and watch the latest Bible movie and feel like they got their God fix, you know, for the year or for the week or for the month or whatever, you know. Well, I believe in the Bible. I just watched the movie The Exodus, Gods and Kings, you know. anyway, so what are some of the errors that are coming out about this movie? riddled with errors, it seems like, and I've made note of two that I'd share with you. Number one is that they're saying that the Nile River turns red because of alligators eating people. That's why the river turned red. I don't know if that's true. That's one of the reviews I read online, that they're saying that the river turns red because alligators eat people. And it's not because God tells Moses to tell Aaron to put his hand, his rod, over the waters of Egypt. No, it's alligators eat people. I don't know if that's true. I'll wait for, you know, some of you guys to see the movie and let me know if that's really, in fact, what happens. But the second error I thought that I saw that was glaringly obvious was in the trailer that you just saw at the beginning of this video. It says that 400,000 slaves, they're going to go get 400,000 slaves. Well, the IMDb.com, Internet Movie Database that you can find online, in its storyline says 600,000 slaves for this movie is what is being portrayed. They're both wrong. We know from Scripture, if you look at the book of Numbers, it says right there in the book of Numbers that there were over 600,000 men who were counted. 600,000 men, over 600, that were over the age of 20 and to be counted for war. Well, that's not counting the very elderly, the women, and the children. In fact, estimates are that 3 and 5 million people left Egypt. Not just Hebrews, but also people whom Egypt had conquered. See, Egypt is the superpower of the day. They've conquered a lot of people. And so if you see, you know, you living as one of the conquered in a country, the country of whom conquered you, and you see their rear end getting handed to them by a bunch of Hebrews, and they're getting ready to leave, the crops are dead, all the livestock are dead, the cattle, there's nothing really to stay for. And your enemy, the people who conquered you, have now been really decimated, and they're on their knees, brought to their knees by some strange god, and the people of that god are leaving. You would get, well, the getting is good. And so that's what historians, and I believe is true, a lot of people left with the Hebrews. And that's kind of addressed in Exodus chapter 12, when Moses says, what do I do with all these people? And God says, if they get circumcised, and if they keep my commandments, and if they keep the Passover, they indeed shall be counted like the native born, and there will be one Torah, one for you and the homeborn, and one for the Gentile who lives among you, and he shall be homeborn, just like you. He shall be counted as the native born. And so one Torah, both for the Hebrew, the native born, and for the Gentile. And once that Gentile keeps Passover, he is like the native born. There's no difference. So that it's kind of addressed there. So that means really a lot of people came out of Egypt with them, and it's really speculated that Jephunneh, the father of Caleb, who belonged to the tribe of Judah, Jephunneh, his father, was one who was grafted in during that Exodus. There's a good case to be made for that. Now, I know some people disagree, but again, there's a good case to be made for that. Anyway, do your biblical research on that. It's just like Hollywood to come out and pick a movie that's already done well. I mean, I don't know how many Academy Awards. It doesn't really say how many Academy Awards. Does it say? I don't know. It won a bunch of Academy Awards. It doesn't say how many, but it won some. And either way, Hollywood picks a movie that's won a bunch of Academy Awards. Let's redo it and make some more money. When really, chances are, the reason this won a lot of Academy Awards was because the acting was so good. Not because it was scripturally correct, because it did make a lot of mistakes and errors. However, I mean, it was Charlton Heston. He was known forever until the day he died for that role that he played in The Ten Commandments. Yul Brynner, again, was known for the role he played as Pharaoh in the movie The Ten Commandments. And so I don't think Christian Bale and whoever this guy is they got for Pharaoh is going to top that. But you know, Hollywood sees dollar signs. They don't see anything else. It's the same way for The Alamo. They redid The Alamo with the guy who was married to Angelina Jolie. I don't remember what his name was, but once John Wayne does a movie, that's it. You can't redo it. True Grit was another example. They got whatever his name was, Big Lebowski guy, to do a redo of a John Wayne movie, True Grit. I'm sorry, but again, another movie where Oscars were won, and you know, didn't. It's ridiculous. Hollywood sees dollar signs. They don't say anything else. They just want to redo everything. Again, this is all distractions. Why is it a distraction? The enemy does not want you to know that there is a greater Exodus coming, folks. That's the topic of this video. There is a greater Exodus coming. Let's just keep an eye on what's going on. Remember the old Exodus? Yeah, that was a great story. Let's tell that story. There's a greater Exodus coming, folks. Let's look at some of these verses right here. Look at this in, let's go to Jeremiah chapter 16. Starting at verse 14. Therefore, behold, the days come, says the Lord, that it shall no more be said, the Lord lives that brought up the children of Israel out of the land of Egypt. But the Lord lives that brought up the children of Israel from the land of the north and from the lands whither he has driven them, and will bring them again into the land that I gave unto their fathers. This is the greater Exodus. The reason it's called greater is because it says that they'll no longer remember the first one. You know, the one they're making movies about. They're not going to remember that one anymore. There's going to be a bigger one where he brings people not just from one country, Egypt, but he's going to bring them back from the four corners of the earth. You're going to cross oceans this time, folks. That's going to indeed be a greater Exodus. And it's going to be more people. It's going to be a lot more people. If it's going to be greater, it's going to have to be greater. That's where the word greater says no more will they remember the old ones. The old Exodus, the first Exodus. They're going to remember the time when he again, the second time. Let's go look at Jeremiah chapter 23. Therefore, behold, the days come, says the Lord, that they shall no more say the Lord lives which brought up the children out of the land of Egypt, but the Lord lives which brought up and led the seed of the house of Israel out of the north country and from all the countries where I have driven them, and they shall dwell in their own land. Okay, two times in the same book, the same prophet makes the same statement. No more will they remember the time when I brought them out of the land of Egypt, but they're going to remember from where I brought them out of the four corners of the earth. From all the countries where I've driven them, I'm going to regather them. Check out Isaiah chapter 11. And it shall come to pass in that day that the Lord shall set his hand again, the second time, to recover the remnant of his people, which shall be left from Assyria and from Egypt and from Pathros and from Cush and from Elam and from Shinar and from Hamath and from the islands of the sea. The second time. It's the second Exodus. The greater Exodus. It's a bigger Exodus. See, he's not bringing us out of Egypt. He's bringing us out from everywhere we've been scattered. Because, see, some people don't understand that, see, there's two houses. There was a northern kingdom, the house of Israel. And then there was a southern kingdom, the house of Judah. The house of Israel was scattered amongst the heathen and became great amongst the Gentiles. And that's the blessing that Jacob gave Ephraim, the son of Joseph. The son of Joseph. That's also called the house of Israel, the house of Joseph. Ephraim, God said, you will be great amongst the nations. How will you be great? You're going to get scattered there. And one day, I will bring you back. One day I will bring you back. And that's what the prophets are talking about. All of the major prophets, all of the minor prophets, and even the writings of Psalms and our Messiah Yeshua in the New Testament talk about and give signs of the greater Exodus. We're going to do a video series on this at some point. But I want you to understand right now, this movie, The Exodus, that's coming out, I don't think it's a mistake that it's coming out now. It's keeping people distracted. You got this other movie coming out. It's the retelling. Or is it already out? Maybe it's already out. It's the retelling of the rapture, you know, that Kirk Cameron did. And we've been picking on Kirk Cameron for a while here on this channel. But, you know, they're redoing his movie. And I think even Kirk refuted the rapture idea. I think he's turned his back on that now. But anyway, they're redoing that movie. And they're retelling the story of the Exodus. They're keeping you distracted on what has happened before and what you should be looking forward to, the rapture, when in reality, the scripture says something completely and entirely different. Go home, read your Bible. Thanks.